described and captioned media program. In the classroom and online, dcmp.org.
Ambrose Video Publishing Incorporated presents A History of Chinese American Achievement in the United States. Chinese Americans Spread Their Wings.
His wars.
A sign, Cathay Bank.
Created their own institutions. Introduced mainstream Americans to new forms of art and health.
A painting of a dragon.
And finally, in an unprecedented manner, contributed to the greater American economy through remarkable entrepreneurial enterprises.
A man eats at Panda Express.
This little-known story of Chinese Americans is revealed in A History of Chinese American Achievement in the United States.
In a movie, Bruce Lee rips off a bloody shirt sleeve. A title appears, A History of Chinese American Achievement in the United States. The host, backdropped by a collage of portraits.
As America moved towards the 20th century, it experienced a time of weak presidents and the rise of the industrial monopolies. It was the era of laissez-faire economics. Hello, I'm Archie Kao. With this program of A History of Chinese American Achievement in the United States, remarkable things began to happen. In spite of anti-Chinese sentiments, Chinese Americans flourished for the first time as individual achievers, becoming Americans as much as Chinese, and beginning a long legacy of individual Chinese American accomplishment that would carry forward into the 21st century.
Archie steps away as the title appears, Chinese Americans Spread Their Wings. Now back to the host, backdropped by a black and white photo of two Chinese men in a shop.
Every minority in America has had to fight for their civil rights. For Chinese Americans, this fight began with the case of San Francisco's Chinese laundryman.
Words read, 1886, San Francisco's Chinese American laundrymen sue for equal rights. In an old photo, a shop sign reads, washing and ironing.
The discrimination is therefore illegal, and the public administration which enforces it is a denial of the equal protection of the laws and a violation of the 14th Amendment of the Constitution. The imprisonment of the petitioners is therefore illegal, and they must be discharged.
A painted portrait of a man with a trim gray beard.
With these words spoken by Justice Thomas Stanley Matthews, the United States Supreme Court in the case of Yik Wo versus Hopkins decided that laws have to be applied equally to all people in America, even non-citizens.
Chinese Americans sit outside a wood-sided laundry building.
It was an astonishing decision at the time, especially given the mood of the country toward the plaintiffs involved, Chinese American immigrants.
In modern footage, Chinese Americans browse a market.
But that's only half of the story. The decision would ripple through history even to the 21st century.
In an old photo, a crowd poses around a pair of locomotives.
Since the completion of
the described and captioned media program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deaf-blind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a center for training and evaluation of any service provider desiring to appear on the DCMP's approved lists of description and captioning service providers. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.